Welcome back, guys. So today I'm going to be giving you an overview, a little sneak peek at a Windows PC emulation station build that is being worked on that I think is pretty amazing. So this is coming from the team who did the Dynamo Arcade build for RetroPie, the arcade-only attract mode build that I thought was really awesome. That one was like 32 gigabytes. I did do a video on it if you want to check it out. That was one of my all-time favorite, you know, Raspberry Pi, RetroPie builds. But this one's for your Windows PC, so we're going to have a lot more compatibility. We have tons of stuff here. This build right now that we're looking at is an early version. It does not include everything that's going to be on the final one. So from what I understand, they're going to be adding a lot more amazing stuff. Right now, the build, the preview that I have, I believe is like 64 gigabytes. The final version is going to be closer to 128. And include stuff like a Thomas Wave. At least that's what I'm hearing. So I can't wait for that. But this build, you've got arcade stuff, Atari 2600, 7800, Atari Jaguar, Dreamcast, Famicom, Game Gear, Game Boy, Game Boy Advance, Game Boy Color, Master System, Mega Drive, Nintendo 64, Neo Geo, NES, PC Engine, PlayStation 1, Sega Saturn, 32X, Sega CD, Super Famicom, SG-1000, Super Nintendo, TurboGrafx-16. There is a lot of cool stuff here. I think the front end, the way this is put together, how everything flows and looks, would definitely be awesome to be used in like a little bar top or even an arcade cabinet that you have put together. So with this being a smaller build, you know, some people, they want, you know, them terabytes. They want those crazy huge builds. And I get it, man. But if you just want something small that is easily manageable, that you don't have to have a dedicated hard drive for, you can use a flash drive if you really wanted to, this is it. This has a huge selection of awesome games. Yeah, each system's not going to have their full library of games, but I think the selection that they've put on this so far is pretty darn sweet. And like I said, they're going to be adding quite a bit more with additional systems and games. I mean, this thing with the arcade, they have Killer Instinct 1 and 2, and it plays flawlessly on my PC. You know, they have Sega Saturn, Sega CD, Dreamcast, PlayStation. You know, some of those play decently well on the Raspberry Pi 3, but you're not getting Saturn. You're not getting full Dreamcast support. Even Nintendo 64 lags quite a bit, you know, with certain games on the Raspberry Pi. This build can be ran on a fairly low-end PC. If your PC's from like 1991, you're gonna struggle with some things here. I mean, that's kind of a given. But this is something that can be ran on a fairly cheap system. You know, those Dell Optiplexes that you find out there for $100 or whatever will be able to run this thing. There's a lot of possibilities, and that's why I really dig stuff like this on the PC side of emulation. Because there's just a lot more you could do than with a single board computer. And typically, it's a lot easier to get going, you know, being able to configure things and that kind of stuff, especially with Emulation Station, in my opinion. They did put a lot of work on this with the graphics, the art, the videos. Doing all this custom stuff, I think, is pretty sweet. And it's also very simple to put together your controls. The build comes with instructions. These guys know what's up, man. They give you what you need. Tells you how to run it, what you need to do, how to set up your controls. All very easy stuff. I downloaded this and just boom, I started playing. So that was definitely sweet. This can be played in windowed mode or full screen. And you guys know there's ways you can have your system just boot up and just automatically run a front end like this. So for this just being all ready to go, all you have to do essentially is set up your controls. I think it's pretty sweet. But for the rest of the video, I'm just going to be quiet, let you guys see the list of games that are included for all the systems here. So far from my counts, arcade, the arcade classics has 52 games. There's two games that aren't listed on the screen, but those are going to be the two Killer Instinct games. Those are like bonuses. And then the rest of the systems are going to have 25 games each. Of a nice little selection. So doesn't encompass the full library, but still, I think it's really awesome to fiddle around with this, play some games on the PC. So here you go. Watch the rest of the games. see what's on here. And once the final build is done, we'll be doing a lot more content on this, showing the setup, I mean, which is pretty darn easy, showing some more gameplay and just seeing what has been added. So I'll refer back to this video once that video comes out, because I'm not going to go through all the games again. But there you go. Enjoy. Appreciate it. We'll be right back.
Quest to rescue. Yes.